a mystery to me. We have agreed with which we have agreed. And you think you have to want more than you need. Until you have it all, you won't be free. Society, you're a crazy breed. I hope you're not lonely without me. When you want more than you have, you think you need. And when you think more than you want, your thoughts begin to bleed. I think I need to find a bigger place. 'Cause when you have more than you think, you need more space. Society, you're a crazy breed. I hope you're not lonely without me. Society, crazy indeed. I hope you're not lonely without me.
YouTubers, today is day number 2 in Temagami, and fortunately we got in pretty late last night as the sun was setting, so we didn't have much time to record, but I'm doing it this morning just before we leave on our trip through Diamond Lake, I think Ferguson Bay, but I'll double check that once we take a look at the map. So just wanted to do a quick peek on our site and what we lived through for the last at least 12 hours anyway, and we're pretty high up, so we're getting the wind at us. We had one of the tents posted right there behind my pack, and the other one here just to the left of that boulder. So decent site, good size. Only problem was is the actual wind, because we're up so high. We're going to be actually going straight across, directly across this bay here, and that's our next portage. I believe it's a 450 odd portage into Ferguson, if I'm not mistaken, but we'll have to take a look at that. There are the boys there loading up the canoes, and we're going to get going.
We passed upon the stair, spoken wasn't well, although I wasn't there, said I was his friend.
Which is Wednesday. We are on Wamakima. What the hell is this lake called? Obabika Lake. And yeah, we were going through one hell of a trip yesterday. We were misdiverted in a bend. On the way here, we took the wrong route and we had gone through hell. Six beaver dams up, six beaver dams down. So we lost about 3 hours on our trip. We're not even supposed to be on this lake. We're supposed to be down to the left-hand side on a 940 meter portage, and we're supposed to be on the following lake after that. But so we're about three and a half hours behind. Hopefully we'll make it up today. So our setup, our campfire that we couldn't get started worth a shit. We tried for hours and hours. Everything was just too soaking wet. Yesterday's rainfall. So we had our communal tent hanging down over here over these chairs. Birch, not the best wood to start a fire with. There's some of the boys there. So we had our gear over here tarped up in the back spot over there was where one tent was, and this was a spot for a second. Our canoes are right behind that camouflage chair right on the bottom. So we're packing up, we're on our way to the next portage, and we'll do some more videoing later. Obabika, going through the 940 onto Obabika Inlet, and we're going to be staying in around this area here at Black Triangle, just before Devil's Bay. So here's the portage, which is what we're about to do right now, and again, it's a 940 meter. See you on the other side. Just finished the 620 meter portage, and as you can see, not too bad of a portage. This is probably one of the worst parts, all the rocks that we had to maneuver, and just around that bend, maybe 100-150 meters, a whole bunch of logs on the floor because it was quite swampy. That was a little tricky, but this is what you can look to when you're going into Devil's Bay in Temagami off at 620. I can't remember the name of the lake prior to this. Something Inlet. I'll type it in text bold when I post it on YouTube. Lots of birch. Total different forest from what I'm generally used to, or that we're generally used to, where birch is very rare. But you can see the abundance of birch here in Temagami. Portages, for the most part, have been pretty easy. I'm just going to walk you back here to the end point where all the guys are. They've been pretty easy, except for approximately two or three out of the eight portages that we've done. One of them was 400 and something odd meters, and it was a killer. Right beside a river, almost cliff-like scenario, bringing up the canoes, which we had to drag as opposed to the ordinary over-the-head kind of ordeal. And here we go into Devil's Bay. Guys, what was the name of the lake prior to this? Obobika Inlet. So from Obobika Inlet to Devil's Bay, 620 meter portage. Just giving you a little sneak peek, and that's what you have to look forward to once you get out.
When you only got 100 years to live.
Here we are. Having to cut the day short. It's 2:10 on day number 5. We're actually on Devil's Bay, probably about an hour after the 620 meter portage. We had to cut it short for that simple fact. Not so close to the shore, but if you look out, you see white caps all the way around. We were actually supposed to make our way northeast and around that bend for our stretch to go home, but a little too dangerous to cross this bay with these high winds. So we cut it short. We've decided to stay in Devil's Bay before we make our cross, hopefully tomorrow morning nice and early, so we don't get this wind on our sides. We've decided to stay at this campsite right here on the west side of the bay, and not the best looking site. Difficult to find a spot to pitch your tents, especially if you have pegs. We're making a communal site, possibly moving the fire pit down there because the wind's coming in pretty bad. So this is what we're up against on day number 5. Not too many places for tents, but we're gonna see if we can put both here. Got our stuff out to dry, and this is what we're gonna call home for day number 5. So I'm sure I'll be recording again tomorrow when we're making our way out. Until then, we'll talk soon. Ferguson Bay in Temagami. Very windy day, approximately 5 o'clock. See the sun coming down. It took us a good 3.5-4 hours to get to this point. We did end up leaving Whitefish North Arm, even though the temperature and the The waves were pretty brutal, but we pulled through. And this is what we had to pretty much contend with. Sorry for the wind there, but about 2 foot, 2.5 foot swells in canoes, and it just took us forever to get to this point. But lovely part is we have a phenomenal treat, which is right there. That is one heck of a view. You're looking up probably 200 odd feet to the tip. And just around that bend is where we need to go for one more portage of 795, which will bring us back to Red Squirrel. So, beautiful, gorgeous, love Temagami. So much different than Algonquin Park. Again, you know, 3.5 odd hours north of Algonquin. Gorgeous view. So this is where we originally started. Red Squirrel to Ferguson Bay. We came down and we went around a peninsula bay way down there. And that's where we stayed our first night. And that's where we started our approximately 80 kilometer trek, maybe a little bit more. All the way around to this point once again. So one big loop. And there's our view once again. Beautiful. Well, until the next video, we'll be making our way out to Red Squirrel and making our way back to the truck, which will be exiting Temagami on Saturday, hopefully by about noon. See you then. From Ferguson Bay to Red Squirrel, and that's pretty much where we started, and we are going this way here. It looks like a pine's fell in the last week. Wasn't here last week when we came. Open over like so. So yeah, 6 day out, making our way through the 700, I believe it's 795, to Red Squirrel. Fortunately, the river that runs beside Red Squirrel can't be run. It's too many rocks. And the water depth just isn't there, so can't bypass the portage, you end up having to do it. But that's the fun of doing these canoe trips. So I'll turn you back to the portage here. Believe it or not, out of the 9 or 8 portages that we've done, this is probably one of the most difficult. I wouldn't say the most difficult, but one of the, because of all the inclines and declines and footing. All these little rocks can take toll on you. Lucky enough, going out, we're a lot lighter than going in. So, just to say, our packs are a lot lighter. We usually don't one time the canoes and the packs together. It could be a little dangerous, number one. And very heavy. So, we try to do a 2-trip. First with the packs, then go back with the canoes. And yeah, it does take a little bit longer, but the end result is easier on the back and longer walk, pretty much. You can hear the river off to the left, which is what we're bypassing. So this is your typical Temagami portage. I'll do a little bit more of a video when we get to the end. Somebody cut a nice log here. See, that's what they do. People respecting other hikers and canoeists and cutting logs as you go down. But they obviously must have had a chainsaw, so. Okay, moving on. Looks like we're coming close to the end of the 795. Going from Ferguson Lake and Temagami to Red Squirrel. And our access point, or our entry point, is just at the end of Red Squirrel, which should probably take us about 45 minutes or so to get back to the Jeep and trailer, and we can make our way back into the city of Toronto. Looking at about 5.5-6 hour drive, but I'm sure we'll be stopping into McDonald's in Huntsville. Gotta get those fats. Anyway, that's wishful thinking. Huntsville's probably a good hour and a half once we get onto Highway 11. But beautiful scenery here. Things that you just don't see in Algonquin. Different type of forest, rock cliffs, and a lot more birch, which in Algonquin is quite scarce, but here it's in abundance. It makes for a beautiful forest. And here we go. Access of Red Squirrel. And that's pretty much where the river starts. Goes into the left and goes right downstream, all rocky. So that's why we took that path. So we dump in the pack right over here, go back for the canoe, and do this all over again. We'll see you soon.
I've paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence but committed no crime. And bad mistakes